I'm gonna let my phone charge until we actually start.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes, I'm guessing that's live.
Yeah.
So,
what's up, everybody?
Yeah, how's it going, everybody? We have a table.
We got a table now. We're slowly upgrading.
Yeah.
Slowly.
We're slowly upgrading, and we have some Coors Light here.
Yep.
And we're supporting the Lakers, some and Coors Light.
Lakers, Coors Light. We got the Camels.
Yes, dude. Jen.
Yeah, dude.
And we got Kool-Aid.
Kool-Aid? Man, Black Lives Matter would love us right now.
Most likely. I love it.
I love it.
Yeah. I don't care if they do. I like it.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, cheers.
Cheers,
brother. So, what is this, like episode 26 or something?
26, yeah, because the guy last week was...
That's right.
Dressed up.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, I didn't really dress up. I just threw on a fucking blazer.
That works.
Yeah, it worked, though. This is great. I feel very comfortable.
Right? I'm very comfortable right here, I guess.
This is much better. Dude, just imagine, we started in the front seat of my car doing this 26 episodes ago. You can go ahead and check it out.
We're in a parking lot in a car doing this.
Yeah, now we're in a garage with a table. You would be surprised how fucking this... If you've been doing episodes in a car, this is a fucking upgrade.
This is a luxury.
Yeah, this is from the front seat of your car
to the back seat for more room.
Yeah. That was working, though.
That worked, because we had plenty of room.
You had a lot of room.
I had plenty of room.
Right. Yeah, you had a lot of room. I did not.
And we were using the same tripod that's on right now, but upside down.
Yeah. Hanging off of
the visors.
The visors.
Yeah, man.
Holy crap.
That's some good shit, man. All right.
Yeah. If that's not calling using what you got...
I don't know.
I don't know what is, man.
I don't fucking know, man. We're still using what we got.
Serious.
We're practically still using everything that we had. Yeah.
But now there's a table.
There's a table. Unfortunately, all this is going to come. The availability of the garage is going to come to an end.
Yes.
Actually, once I get my car back, so probably soon.
Yeah.
So we might be back.
We'll probably be back in the car. We'll somehow fit this into the car.
I'm just kidding. We'll see. We will see how that all works out. Because maybe I could swing something. I might be able to swing something to where we're able to use the garage still. So
start swinging things.
Well, I was thinking, if my brother puts his car back in here, instead of having to take the whole car out, have him clear out half of the garage, you know, just pull the car out a bit so that we can have space to do it over there.
But, okay.
Well, we'll see. This is all, it's all gonna happen.
Well, and that white wall would work over there.
That would be nice if we could go over there.
And then we could just put this over there.
So,
speculations.
It is speculation. So, we will see. Yeah, there's an outlet over there, huh? That was the one I wanted to use before. Just turned that into a whole area. It just turns into an office.
Yeah.
I got my computer down here. Hey, man.
Yeah.
Where are you?
I don't even go upstairs anymore.
I don't even go upstairs anymore. I was like, wait a minute. You just walk in, I'm beaten off. Like, oh!
Oh, God. Oh, Justin, your wiener.
I'm like, get out of here. You guys pull us to hell. Get the fuck out of here.
Okay. You just see me roll out from under the garage door.
Roll from under the garage door. Hey, dude, whoa!
Just
do the reverse roll. You don't even get up.
Just roll right back out. Oh, God, it's our wiener.
Dude, that fucking scenario when we first rolled up, dude. We went and got beer and we left the garage door cracked a little bit. So
yes.
You can only see a couple of chairs and we rolled back up. And I was like, dude, what if we rolled up and you saw our legs in the chairs? And then when we got closer, you could hear us talking.
Yeah, we've slowly been having these Twilight Zone like stories.
I don't know. They come out well.
Yeah, they do.
And they we were saying if like we got out of the car and we could hear us in here talking about what we were talking about right before we left to go get beer.
Yeah. And then like we could either start disappearing or
Jesus.
I don't know.
I don't know. Nuts. But or as you see, you know, because I was like, oh, can you roll under the garage door? As you're rolling out, the other you is disappearing as it rolls out
under the garage door. Nuts.
And then as I come out, I just like right here, just lying like right where the garage is, like our other selves are disappearing, and then then it's just us again. It's like
what? I was just like, what the fuck was in this beer?
But we wouldn't have drank it yet.
Yeah, we wouldn't have drank it anyway.
Yeah.
And so, if I got back, I'm like, hey, did we leave? He's like, no, you guys never left. Like,
fuck. Oh, man. So, Twilight episode.
Twilight. Hey, that's a Twilight episode idea there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have to keep that in mind, you know? make something out of it one day. Make money.
Yeah. Make millions of dollars.
All right. We should just start writing our own scripts, our own screenplays.
Yeah.
Yeah, and just be like...
I don't see why not,
and then
man.
Give it to someone who could do something with it.
Yeah. Give me money.
Yeah,
I make that shit.
Read this story. If you like it, you can have it, but you gotta give me some money.
It's like, just throws $20.
There you go, man. 2 weeks later, he made $5 million off it. Hey, do you think that $20 could turn into like...
Yeah, can
you know,
like add five zeros?
Yeah. Some zeros to this 20 that you gave.
You just have it on the $20 bill, you just start adding zeros on. Can you turn this into something real?
Please. Yeah. Oh, they all asking nicely. Please.
Fucking Roger Rabbit.
Please.
Well, should we, well, you guys just got our first scenario of it, but I guess should we just start the show? This is how, oh shit. Hey, look at that.
Oh. Garageception. Exactly, Dan. Fucking garageception.
I look so fucking comfortable.
Hell yeah, dude.
I'm gonna take down my arm. I'm gonna take down my arms because that doesn't look professional for some reason.
Have it right here.
Two viewers.
I'm one of them.
Birdo? Yeah, Birdo's watching. Alright. Well.
Yeah. Alright. Let's do this.
Okay. Actually, just scoop them.
Yo, yo, Birdo.
Alright, right now we're getting things together.
Or, yeah, we're making sure it's nice.
Yeah, this is the first time set up with a table, so, cool.
I like it. I'm gonna do the test closer. There you go.
All right. Fuck it. Well, for everybody that is still watching right now, thank you guys for being so vigilant and watching us right when we actually start. But for anybody that is going to be tuning in here for a moment, thank you so much for joining the FAD. My name is Bryant.
I'm Justin.
How's it going? Thank you guys so much for joining us. So this week we do have some good topics for you. We have a little bit on social media.
The stuff that everyone's been seeing on social media.
Yes, we got...
If you've been on Facebook, which you're all on Facebook right now,
yeah.
You are not blind to what's been going on.
Yeah, so first we'll go over Pokemon Go. We got a little bit of Hillary Clinton, Black Lives Matter. So we'll go ahead and talk about all that stuff, so stay tuned.
Sure,
but, dude, so how's it going, man?
Good, man. Fucking had a pretty good weekend. We're supposed to go to Vegas this weekend for my brother's birthday, but it didn't happen. Which is okay.
I thought you did.
No, I didn't. Yeah. I ended up just laying low. Didn't do anything Saturday. And then Sunday, my brothers and I, we went to the comedy show over there Ontario.
That's right.
And it was a good show. Jimbo from 96.7 KKRX. You rock! You fucking...
I heard you were there.
Yes, he's there, and yeah, that guy's awesome, man. I hung out with him for a little bit. He's fucking awesome.
That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah. he's always a good time. He's funny as all hell.
This guy's a superstar. He hangs out with cool people. I'm a loser.
And then, of course, the after party, the comedy show after party is at 4th and Mill, which... If you haven't been to 4th and Mill, it's over there, right by Ontario Mills. It's on the corner of 4th and Milliken.
Yeah.
Right by the UPS store.
4th and Mill off 4th and Milliken.
Yep, exactly. They're pretty original.
Yeah.
Hey, it works. Yeah. But yeah, they're a pretty good place. Yeah, you can shoot some pool there, buy some cheap drinks. Their happy hour is always good. We were getting $3 well drinks there. Come on. It's hard to beat that.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was a good time. So shout out to Jimbo. You're awesome, Jimbo.
Jimbo.
You fucking rock. And Sebastian. Thank you, Sebastian. He was the headliner for that show, but he is friends with my brother, and that's how we got it for
Sebastian
free. Sebastian's, I don't know his last name.
Is he like an Italian?
Italian, Mexican, something like that.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Holy crap. That's cool. Yeah. I thought you were talking about that guy was just a friend that got you into the show.
No, correct. He was a, correction. He was the headliner for
the
show.
Oh, wow. That's
crazy.
So
it was
cool.
His show. Yeah, it was his show. So.
Very cool.
Yeah, it was a good show. He was funny. He was ragging on my brother. I guess my brother was saying he does it every time he goes and sees him. And he likes to it's pretty much full crowd interaction. That's his show. Yeah. It's full crowd interaction. He's pretty good at it.
That's cool.
So... Yeah.
That's really cool that, you know, and most of the time you usually see, like, comedians.
Like
they'll go.
Scenarios and
yeah.
Stuff.
They'll just go off somebody right in front of the crowd, but mainly they stick to their script.
Yeah.
You know?
Dude, this guy did not have a script coming up, and I
guess
he's really good at it, and I think that's pretty amazing. He's able to just talk to the crowd, talk shit on this person, that person, that person.
Yeah.
And yeah, and it's funny.
It's like a Nutty Professor when Dave Chappelle was the comedian.
I remember Nutty Professor.
Yeah, the first Nutty Professor, Dave Chappelle was a comedian guy, but he was just making fun of everybody in the crowd.
Yeah.
And then he makes fun of the Nutty Professor because he's fat, yada, yada, yada. But yeah. Right, see that's cool that a comedian can actually just go off of improv.
Yeah.
Right? You don't see it too often.
Not really. There was another fucking guy there. His name was Stoner Rob.
Nice.
I remember seeing him at 4th and Mill. I said, what's up to him? He obviously is a stoner. Like,
yeah.
He dresses like a full Rastafarian stoner, you know? It's pretty fucking funny.
Yo. What's up, Roland?
Yo. But, yeah, dude, that guy was just like, all of his jokes were just weed jokes, and I was like fucking cracking up.
Man, that's cool, man. And fucking Dan... Thank you. He said, loving you is easy because you're beautiful,
because
Justin.
Beautiful. Yes. Thank you.
I am beautiful.
Yeah, so we're 26 episodes in.
Yeah.
We're loving it.
It's growing. Every single time it's growing. And actually, the mics, if you guys know me personally, I actually got the mics to start working. Enrique,
yes.
Thank you. I am definitely going to give you a shout out because honestly, he was
thank
the one
brother.
That figured out how to go ahead and make that work.
Sweet. Thank you, Enrique.
Yeah
you are definitely a lifesaver for us because that was a fucking headache.
Yeah,
for us.
That was.
I'm
a
sure
headache.
Brian has told you all about it.
Yeah, I owe sucking his dick and buying him a beer. So.
Can I watch?
But thank you, Enrique. But
cool,
yeah, so next week,
next week, look forward to Immaculate Sound.
Yes, the tone of my voice.
My voice is fucking powerful.
I can see the guy.
Sorry.
I did not mean to blow your mind.
To blow your mind.
Oh, man. Tenacious D, man.
Fucking Tenacious D, dude.
Yeah, I fucking love Tenacious D.
Right? Jack Black, you have done no wrong.
Yes.
I'm sure you have, but...
You're right. You're probably right. You probably have.
Dan said you just jizzed a little.
Nice. Fuck yeah.
You sick motherfucker.
You sick motherfucker. It's like, that's in like the same skit in Tenacious D where the guy, he's like,
oh yeah, in the back. I took a screenshot of that off YouTube so I can make a meme out of it. I haven't yet. I'm like saving that.
He's
and,
like,
and his face is, this looks like he's like, oh my god, and like, almost like miserable ecstasy. It's like too much.
Oh, man.
It's like he's overloaded with it. Like,
dude, so I apparently weirded out some people at 4th and Mill talking about putting rubbing a condom on my mouth before I have sex.
They brought it
Megan
up.
Megan was like,
they brought up the topic, and I just kind of rolled with it, and I'm really good at it now. I mean, I podcast all the time. So I can roll with something really quick.
Yeah.
But a guy, his name's Eric, he was talking about going ahead and blowing up a condom.
In the back of a bus.
Yeah. And I was like, I've never done that because I don't want the CYK jelly, like remnants of the condom on my lips. I just don't want it. So, yeah. So I just rolled off of that. They got really weirded out. Sorry, guys.
Megan, she can't handle it. She's happily married, and she's taken herself out of the whole, perversion life, I guess you could say.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's totally cool.
That sucks.
You know what?
I
it's
love
still,
being perverted.
It's still funny to joke with her, and other anyone, men and women who are married, it's still funny to joke with them about, because it's still there, but they're like, I'm not like that anymore.
Yeah.
and it's like so funny.
Yeah. You're like, oh man, I wish I rubbed condoms on my lips. It's like,
my brother's friend Dave is a perfect example. Okay, this guy, Dave, my brother, they're 4 years older than me. So when I was growing up, they taught this guy David. His name's David Wang.
Yes,
he taught me what perversion was. Like, I did not even know how to be perverted until I met this guy, and he was like the most perverted fucking guy I've ever met. All the way up until he got married like 8 years ago.
Okay.
And after he got married, you know, you joke around with him, and he'd still kind of have it, but he's very, very censored, very put it.
Yes.
Yeah, he's pushed it down real far, and I'm like, all right, that's cool. That's cool. Dan.
All for my boy Justin.
Buy me something, Dan.
What happened, man? I thought you jizzed on the way to go. For me?
No.
For me.
When you
sorry.
When you get the mic, you can do it.
Yeah.
Next week, dude.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Alright, well, fucking. Let's start off with some Pokemon Go.
Okay.
Who here has downloaded Pokemon Go?
Just go ahead and start pointing on the likes. Dude, Pokemon Go is going crazy, man.
Going crazy, man.
Yeah.
Fuck, like, everyone's on it, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, literally everyone. Did you hear they're having a fucking thing this weekend in downtown Riverside? It's a meet. It's a Pokemon Go meetup, so it's from the Friday to Sunday, and
it's days long. I was expecting it to be like, oh, Pokemon meetup. Okay, like 2-3 hours. Okay, so. Oh, that's great.
Nah,
people
man.
Are gonna be stinking.
There's gonna be people just like, I've been standing here for 5 days.
You smell like the undercarriage of a Bulbasaur. It's like that in between the leaf. And, like, his skin, you smell like... That's fucking disgusting. People like, days? That's crazy.
I don't know if everyone's going to be out there the whole time, but it
you
is
know
for
some,
the
you know somebody's
oh,
going to be out there.
It will be until a cop comes and says, yo, go home. Get the fuck out of here. In Sydney, there was a meetup of 2,000. Yeah.
Holy shit.
Around that number. I know that the one
that
is
nuts.
I checked yesterday. Well, I was invited to it. So I saw yesterday that there's over 1,000 people RSVP'd for the event in downtown this weekend. So I'm thinking it might be something like that. There's just going to be thousands of people like, fuck, Montclair Mall today. Every single person had a phone. There it is. I've yet to see... like somebody on the street, you know? Like,
I saw it the other day.
You seen it? I'm waiting to see it so I can take a picture of
it. It was that day that I put on Facebook that I walked down the street to go ahead and try to find this Pokemon, yeah, and it was in somebody's house. So I was like,
"Did you knock on their door?"
I know.
Oh my god! Dude, hey, please.
Yeah. Excuse me. Can I barge into your house to catch this Sandshrew? I swear it's in your backyard, and I won't steal
and
anything.
I fucking need it. I need it more than you do.
I fucking need it. It's the face of... So I walked down the street. It was like a block and a half. And then I walked back home, and I wasn't able to go ahead and catch it, but I went over to a friend's house, and all these Pokemon are in the park next to my house.
Okay.
So I was like, I'm going to drive over there before I go to my friend's house.
Oh, yeah, look, he's becoming one of them.
And I drive by, and I stop where they are, and I see this kid driving by with a fucking Ash Ketchum hat, looking at his phone.
Oh, and he's driving?
And he's driving.
Please do not do that, people. Please. There's enough people causing accidents just because they're on their phone.
That
text message.
Like that guy that died because he went and tried to catch a Pokemon on the freeway?
Jesus.
But we'll get into that in a second. But there was another guy. He was walking. I think he lives in the apartments next to the park. So he walks by, and he's just, I can see him looking at his phone. He walks towards the park, and then he just walks back. And I was like, I know exactly what you're doing right now.
Catching Pokemon.
So, it's going crazy, but apparently, some guy tried to get onto the freeway to go ahead and catch a Pokemon and died.
Wow.
Killed himself.
Hey, you know what? I hate to put it so bluntly, but fucking...
It's what you get?
No, what's it called?
Darwinism?
Is it Darwinism?
Darwin?
I forget. But it's the, you're weeding out. Let nature take care of itself. Nature's taking care of itself.
Yeah.
I'm not even kidding, dude. If my kid wouldn't be dumb enough to do that. I'm so like, to go onto the freeway to catch a Pokemon? Dude, God, come on.
That's like an addiction to the max. Like, that person either had to be on drugs or just like, you are.
Yeah, I'm thinking drugs maybe, you know?
Something's not like.
Who knows, man?
I don't know. But who knows, you know?
What Dan said, Darwinism, there you go. The girl who found a dead body. I read part of the article, but I was distracted, so I didn't read it all. But she found it. Did you read the story at all?
I didn't, but I saw the.
You saw the article.
Yeah,
that's crazy, dude. But that's good. In a way, ended up being a good thing.
Maybe what this, and you know what, the big argument that's going on about this game is that people are going outside. That this game is getting people to go outside.
Exactly. There's that meme that Michelle Obama has been trying to get people to go outside for 8 years, and Pokemon Go did it in 24 hours.
But it's true. It's like people are outside. But at the same time, people are arguing, well, you know what? It's not really you're outside. You're playing a fucking video game. But, like, so it's like, well, what do you want?
What do you want? That's like telling a kid 15, 20 years ago, oh, you're riding your bike outside? Well, you're not walking.
Seriously.
Yeah, you get more exercise when you walk.
Does nothing impress you? It's like this person's like dead inside. You know, just go outside and play some Pokemon Go. At least he's burning calories. Get the kid a Fitbit.
Exactly, right?
He just burnt, like, he just took, like, 500 steps going and catching a fucking Caterpie down at the park. Like, cool. Just don't die.
That meme on Facebook of the, it's a picture of, like, a old rapist man, and it's just a rare Pokemon inside.
Yeah.
This is how to lure a 28-year-old. And I was like, I thought about it for a second, I'm like, honestly, I would pull out my phone. If I was there, I'd be like, is there something in there?
Yeah, you have to check it out.
Like,
make sure.
They got me.
Yeah, there's a Charizard in there. There's a Mew in there. Like, honestly, if there was a Mew, I think I would actually go for it.
Dude, that's what everyone's waiting for, the Mew and the Mewtwo. Mewtwo is going to be at, like, Area 51 or something.
I liked so much that my phone restarted.
You know, you're right, Dan. The game will die out, like, from what it is now, but I still think that, Who is it? Not Nintendo. The people who are doing that game. It's not Nintendo. It's another company that does Pokemon Go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I forget the name of it.
Okay.
Yeah, but they're just gonna keep adding on updates to keep people interested.
See, there's like 5,000 Pokemon now.
Yeah. Jack had the exact number, 700 and something.
Okay.
Something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But, I'm way off.
That's okay, but that's a lot. I mean, that's coming from, we start off with 151 Pokemon, right?
There isn't even the full 151, because you have to evolve them.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's in itself going to take time.
That's going to take, because you have to catch duplicates and stuff.
Yeah, you have to, you have to go ahead and send them back to Professor Oak to get the whatever.
I don't know. I haven't played it enough. The harder thing with me for playing this game is that you really do have to go out.
It's Nintendo backed.
Oh, it's Nintendo backed. Okay.
So Dan said it's Nintendo backed.
Okay. It's backed by Nintendo. I wish I knew the name of
I don't know. I have no idea.
I think what was I saying? That
cheers, Justin.
It's fucking saying something.
Cheers, everybody. Happy Monday. Hope you guys had a good Monday.
Right?
Just working your asses off.
Right? Hope you guys have been playing a lot of Pokemon Go and catching some good Pokemon.
Steve Reyes said Niantic.
Niantic. That sounds right. Niantic.
So Steve Reyes said it's Niantic.
Thank you, Steve.
Yeah. I like your picture, Steve. cheers. Cheers, everybody. I'm going to down this mother freaker right now.
Oh, really? So it's 25% of total worth, huh? So Nintendo had 25% ownership, or they just received 25% of its worth? Roland?
I also heard Nintendo earned 7.5 billion yen, or 25% of their total worth, according to Forbes. That's interesting. Forbes, I always see the magazines available at one of my old jobs, and from the information that I saw on Forbes, the thing that made me feel like it was legit was that it wasn't exciting. It wasn't exciting to read. You know what I mean?
That's where the best factual information comes from.
Yeah.
This is the boring stuff.
Yeah, it wasn't exciting at all. It was just more like numbers and stats.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, okay. Fair enough, and I'm gonna throw this out now because it's not like a Maxim or anything.
Yeah.
You know, like you get a Maxim and you just like, oh my, you know. But yeah, that's crazy. That's a lot of money, man.
Yeah, that's a lot of money. The first day I read today that the first day that when it got launched, the game made like $7 or $8 million.
Jesus Christ!
Yeah, the first day that Pokemon Go launched.
Oh my god. $7 or $8 million. And
this is a free game. That's all in-game purchases, you know, because it's a free game.
Yeah,
so that's like, dude, like, we're talking about everyone around the fucking world. It's not from a lot of large purchases. This is millions and millions of small purchases.
I guess the most
popular purchase of all of them was the 99. You can pay 99 cents
for a dollar.
For a dollar you can get money, right? In-game currency.
It's 100 coins for 99 cents.
It's actually on par with with regular money. You know,
that's nuts, man. But you know what? And it is like Dan said earlier, the die out.
It'll die out,
but that's everything. You know, that's
true.
That's
everything. It kind of died out for me, but not because I didn't like the game, but because it demanded too much of my time.
Yeah.
That I felt that, you know what, I could spend the next 2 hours right now and go ahead and invest in this game, go out and invest in this game, or I could try to get some shit done. And it's kind of difficult when it's like, well, I should be getting some shit done, you know? I have websites to work on. I got laundry to do. I got graphics to make. I got a computer who's like, please play with me 24/7. I'm just a little bit busy. But I do think if I was 10 years old again, this would be fucking magical. The trading card game was fucking magical for me when I was a kid. You know, so was the Game Boy Red and Blue and Pikachu and Yellow Pikachu.
Oh yeah,
those were huge in my life.
Those, but huge.
And I still have them too.
Yeah.
But
me too.
The trading card game is what like really hit home for me with Pokemon.
Okay.
And I was very invested into the trading card game, and I feel that that's what 10-year-olds now get to feel. They get to feel, you know,
that nostalgia of Pokemon.
The magic of Pokemon that we felt when we were 10.
And now that you say that, they are starting off with the first Pokemon.
Mm-hmm.
So that's actually pretty cool.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So it's
that meme. It's like all these 15 and younger year old kids need to get off Pokemon Go. They don't even know what a fucking Squirtle is. And I'm like, damn right, don't know what a Squirtle is.
Yeah. My lord.
Yeah, their servers are constantly being overloaded and stuff like.
That's crazy
dude,
stuff. Man.
There was a Snapchat. This guy, Jake, out not Jake from Bonnie Julie's Rose, but another Jake out in Norco. He's like 22, 23 now, but he put on a snap the picture of the maintenance screen, and he was bummed. He's like, I'm still crying. I'm like, Jesus, this guy's like super bummed out that the servers are still down. He hasn't been able to get on today. Like,
that's horrible, man.
I'm like, damn,
you
dude.
You need to go do something with yourself.
I couldn't do it.
I don't even know. It's like you said, yet again, to go ahead and reiterate on what you said, it's when you're younger.
Yeah.
When you definitely have that time. It's like, when I was, like, 12, my life was Zelda, or Ocarina of Time, you know? I lived that shit. So, it's like you said, when you have, like, a 14-year-old that's able to go to the park and go places by himself, that's all I would be doing.
Yeah.
But
when I was 10, yeah, of course. It'd be awesome. If this game was around when I was 10, it would be awesome. Like,
yeah.
I would be with my friends mobbing everywhere.
Oh,
like, I would be.
You would, and see, that's great. Hopefully.
And that's
hopefully
what I hope
you're,
to see.
You're with your friends.
Yeah, and that's what I hope to
that.
See. I would be stoked. If I saw, like, a group of kids that were maybe not 10, but maybe, you know, in middle school, mobbing around and there was a group of them, I'd be like, hell yeah, that's what I would have done. When I was your age.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Get out on the streets. Go play some Pokemon Go.
Exercise. Go do your thing. Just don't be a fucking nuisance. That's it.
Yeah.
Don't be a nuisance.
Somebody's going to be a nuisance.
Yeah, that's true because they're like 12.
And like people are like setting people up to go ahead and steal from them because they're in the local area.
Yeah,
or
yeah. With the lures. That's what Roland was saying. Using the fucking lures.
Yeah.
To, like, jack people or steal and steal shit.
So don't go crazy on the people that are going ahead and misusing it. You know, there's always going to be that fucking Roger Klutz from Doug, you know, that's going to go ahead and fucking do something asshole-y. You know, he's going to be an asshole. Somebody's always going to be an asshole.
Someone is.
You know,
especially
just,
with a game that's like this.
Yeah, somebody's going to do some dick shit. You know, find some dead bodies. You know.
Yeah, exactly.
So
exactly.
don't fucking hate on it, cause just, you know, let the kids have their fun.
We've all played MMOs before.
Yes.
We've all played some kind of MMO. This is an MMO that is now on the streets.
Yeah.
This is a real life MMO. So. Catch Pokemon after the show.
Yeah, serious. Let's go catch some Pokemon. After the show. I'm planning on going and walking around this area after I fucking finish this shit. Because I haven't caught anything in this area yet. We're in Corona, California, for anybody that isn't local that's watching right now. So, yeah. So, hopefully you guys are catching some, like, Rapidashes and Gyaradoses and shit.
Yeah, I want to go down to the beach so I get some water Pokemon.
Ooh.
So.
You can actually catch water Pokemon down at the water.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
God damn. I wish I had, like, all the time in the world.
Right?
Yeah.
And money.
And money.
So.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that game, man. But
that's cool.
I do think it's, you know, I do find it just amazing how some people just haven't been able to invest so much into it already.
Yeah.
So I'm like, you know what? I just can't do it. I'm not, I don't know. I can't keep up like that.
Not a kid anymore.
Yeah. But a lot of people our age are posting on Facebook their stuff. Just like, oh, look what I got and all this stuff. I won't say his name, but there's one particular guy. I didn't like him in high school and I probably wouldn't like him now. I don't know why I have him on Facebook. this guy is like posting all the time his updates. He got to like level 13 in a full day. It wasn't even a full day. It wasn't a full day.
Jesus.
He went from level 1 to level 13 in like almost a full day. I'm like, are you fucking kidding? Like, do you do? Like, what do you do? Like, you must be either really rich and really well off.
Yeah.
Or you're on the opposite end of the spectrum, which I don't think he is, knowing what I know about the guy. I think he's on the first part, and so I'm like, damn, that must be nice, man. Like.
Roland, so it turns out two 20-something black dudes and a 40-year-old white guy chilling in the park at 3 a.m. looks strange. It took a bit of talking to convince the cop we weren't doing a drug.
Oh, deal. I read that article. Yeah, okay. The white guy met up with like two black, well, not met up, but ended up with two black guys in the park, and they were just talking Pokemon Go, and a cop thought they were doing some kind of drug deal,
it is 3 a.m.
And it is suspicious.
But I
don't know what kind of relief that the cop got. It's like, oh, these guys are just out here on Pokemon Go. It's like, maybe, shit, you know?
Maybe that was a relief for that officer.
In a way, it can't be bad, right?
Yeah.
Can't be bad.
You know, because usually I bet that cop is finding fucking crack addicts.
Exactly. I'm sure every time that cop comes up on someone, there's something going on.
Who hangs out in a park at 3 a.m. in the morning?
Obviously, you guys are doing something you shouldn't be doing.
Exactly.
But for the first time, that's not the case, you know?
And you're old as fuck. and you're old as fuck. If you're a 40-year-old and you're just, like, in the park at 3 a.m., that would be suspicious as fuck. It's like, why aren't you at home right now, like, tending to your 15 children? So, you know. But that's how it goes. Cheers, Jesse.
Cheers, man. Cheers, everybody. Our six listeners, watchers. Cheers, you guys.
Cheers, everybody. So, you didn't want to go ahead and talk about protesters.
Yes.
Protesters in the streets.
We'll start this in a second.
Okay.
I'm going to do a test here.
Uh-oh. Just a second. Hang with us for a second. If you guys are drinking, I'll just keep drinking until... Wait, what are you doing?
I'm sharing this part right now because we're about to start talking about it.
Okay. Okay, so yeah, we're actually going to go ahead and talk about some protesting that's actually going on in the world right now. A lot of people are standing in the streets, in front of cars, getting ran over. stay with us for a second.
Yeah, so all these fucking problems, man, with, the whole cops being shot thing, I will definitely start this off with, I do not think it's a coincidence at all.
I'm getting old. I don't think it's a coincidence anymore.
There's no coincidence that, you know, it was only about a week ago, maybe a little bit more, that we found out that Hillary got let off by the FBI publicly let off Hillary Clinton.
And then all of a sudden,
cops are shooting everybody. Yeah. All of a sudden, cops are shooting everybody. And it's, in my mind, it's like, this isn't anything new. Cops have been shooting people for years. Years and years, rightfully and wrongfully.
Yeah.
It's been going on for a long time. That's and there's true. Been video, with the rise of social media and everything, the content has always been there.
Yeah.
But it's just, now it's being put on social media to be put in front of everybody.
It's on Facebook Live. Yeah. This is happening on Facebook Live now, which I have something to say about that. No, continue, I'm sorry.
No, go for it.
So, the thing that is actually interesting, and beside Black Lives Matter and all of the media that's going on, Facebook Live is actually taking a turn for, and I think it's messing up a lot of things for politicians or people that are trying to control anything, because you can't control something that is happening right then and there.
Exactly. You can't control it like that.
You can't control it when it's completely spontaneous. But, yeah, so go, keep going, dude.
Well, I think this is what I'm thinking that's happening. You know, it's not a coincidence, like I said. Along with Pokemon Go, you know, dominating the attention of everybody.
That.
The thing that's dominating everyone now is, police killing people, and people killing people, and people killing cops, and people shooting each other, you know? It's like, fuck, like, all of a sudden, in the last week, this has only happened in the last, like, 7 fucking days, that this is all of a sudden a huge problem. And there are protests going on everywhere. They're fucking everywhere.
And it wasn't it, like, 2 weeks ago that it was about transgenders?
Oh, I don't know about 2 weeks ago, but it was 2 months ago, maybe.
That was, like, 3 episodes ago for us.
With transgender, and the whole bathroom thing?
Yeah.
That was wrong. Okay. Yeah, that's been on social media for a couple months.
Okay, I guess it's still stuck in my head that, like, that was something so recent.
It was. You know, it was only a couple months ago.
And it just goes.
Yep. And it was.
We got a problem.
Yep.
We got a problem. Oh shit! Oh, we got a problem. Let's go ahead and make something.
The whole thing is like, dude, we're being distracted. We're all being distracted.
We're being distracted.
And you know, as long as you're aware of that, that's about the best you can do as a citizen is to be aware of it, because it's really you can't prevent the distraction. You can't prevent any of that.
Tall pole. You know? Paul, divide and conquer tactics are wanted by the elites. And
yes.
And Paul, yes. You are a police officer. So for you to go ahead and say this actually means more than I can even fathom.
Yeah.
So
and I know you understand, Paul, about what's going on. You are a big subject of what I'm talking about tonight, Paul.
Exactly.
Because you're part of it. No, you're definitely a big part of.
You're right in the
what's going on. You know?
You're right in the fire. You know, like all of that right there.
There's a lot of opinions on everywhere, especially social media.
Everybody,
there's a lot of opinions everywhere.
Everybody's going to have opinions.
It's hard for me to respect someone else's opinions. I do my best. I'm trying not to be judgmental or anything like that. You know, but it's difficult sometimes when you're talking to someone that's like, how the hell do you really believe that? Are you that selfish? You know, but
people are naturally selfish.
People are selfish. You
people
know?
Are naturally
so
selfish.
So everyone has their own agenda, and you know, people would call me selfish for my opinion.
Yeah.
So
exactly.
Whatever, you know. And actually, here's my opinion about all this.
Yes.
I don't give a shit about all the protesting. I do give a shit about people dying. Of course, I give a shit about that.
Yeah, and that should be. I think that should be a bigger deal.
Yeah, well, and what these protesters are trying to do is they're trying to make it a bigger deal, which is okay. That's totally okay to do that. That's what the purpose of protesting is.
Yes,
and
definitely.
And protesting is supposed to start a movement that's supposed to get somewhere and be productive. Totally fine with that. I would back up anyone who came up to me and says, I want to protest for this reason. Like, wow, okay, you should. Now, part of it is, don't fucking block my way if you're gonna protest. And one example, someone tried to use fucking the grocery, when people picket at grocery stores, you know, and they're like, well, people are there in the middle of the streets. I'm like, yeah, but they're not blocking my fucking way. I could still walk into the store and walk out without anyone physically stopping me.
Tell me your piece.
Tell me
but let me continue
let me
my
go.
Life.
And if you slow me down, I'll let that slide if you slow me down. But but don't you dare fucking bring my path to a stop if I don't want it to be.
But at the same time, it's just like he just said. You have to think about everybody. You can't just think about yourself.
Yeah.
If you got, and it's like something he said earlier. What if somebody was in the car and a mother was giving birth? What if a child was choking on something and they were on to their way to the ER?
If it was an emergency type of situation, where it wasn't an emergency where you need a paramedics flying someone, but it's an emergency enough is, hey, we need to get here ASAP.
Yeah.
You know, we're not trying to drive unsafe. We're not trying to break any laws or drive unsafely. We're just trying to get to A to B as fast as we can.
Yeah.
And then you're stuck. There's a person in front of you. There's a person behind you. There's people side to side. And you're, why the fuck can't we move? Because there's a mob of people over there who won't get the fuck out of the way.
And you know people to not be patient. You know what's going to happen. It's almost like they wanted this to happen. They also wanted it to happen. It's like, let me block a freeway.
The freeways are, it would be the worst ones.
Yeah,
like, I feel the freeway has the most justification for someone to get ran the fuck over.
But, like, what if somebody didn't notice? You're on a freeway, like, what if someone is like, dude, you're traveling like 80 miles an hour, you live in California, dude. You live in California, you know? It's like, it's gonna happen. I don't know. It's just logic to me.
Yeah.
It's just logic to me. I don't know. I'm crazy. Don't fucking listen to me. I'm crazy. I'm just gonna keep drinking.
But I'm all for. I've heard there's been some peaceful protests. There was one off of Lemonine Hamner over there over the weekend. I heard that one was pretty good. I did hear there was one at City Hall in Riverside, right? I don't know how it went, but I haven't seen anything bad, so you can only assume things went well.
Yeah.
You know, like, really. But then I see these other protests where people are... And here's another thing. I'm not saying that, hey, you're not allowed to do this. I'm saying that don't do it the way they're doing it. If you can plan it out with the city... If you can make it an event where it's planned out, the authorities are involved, there's traffic, you know, being diverted and everything, I wouldn't give a shit. I'd be like, okay, I'm still moving. Yeah. I'm still moving. That's fine. They're doing a protest over here. They're getting their point out. Fine. I don't fucking care.
I can still do my thing. Go ahead and do it.
But the problem is people are just like, hey, tonight let's gather 1,000 people and go mob onto the freeway to make a point.
I think that's...
It's like, dude.
All in all, that is impressive to go ahead and gather 1,000 people somewhere like that.
That's true. That's impressive, too. But that is impressive. Where was it? In Oakland, right? Oakland, I think, was when they came down and started mobbing onto the freeway.
And they formed a huge peace sign?
No.
Okay.
That was this weekend. That was in the intersection. I forget where that was.
Okay.
That was like a day or two ago.
That's very artsy of you guys.
Yeah, right?
It's very artsy.
I actually thought that was kind of cool. Okay, from a big piece of stuff. I think that was definitely. Kinda cool. See, that's the thing. People think that I'm just like hating on all these people. It's like I'm not hating on these people and what they're trying to do. I'm really not. And if there was something in it that I took interest, maybe I'd be there too. I just don't take interest in it, you know. But you know, my point stands of like, hey, just come on, be courteous to the people who are not trying to be involved and you're just trying to be on their way somewhere.
Stand
on the sides and be like, hey, this and that. Now they're driving by. All right, I got you.
Yeah.
I see it. I got what you're saying. Thank you.
Thank you for making me aware.
Yeah, thank you for making me aware. I got to clock in 10 minutes.
So, yeah. You know, I got to fucking go.
Or something. You know, I got shit to do. I got shit to do. You know? So.
But, you know. It's, yet again, to go back to what we started off with, it seems very much like a distraction. Don't forget what's going on. You know, that's my piece. Don't forget what's going on. Remember to be vigilant. Remember to be vigilant, everybody, because there's a lot of things that are going on in social media. Like, as much as we are on social media, I do this, we do this, we all do these things for hobbies, you know? Me and Justin, we don't get paid to do these kind of things. We just, you know, have a Monday to go ahead and spare, so, and drink some beer and enjoy with you guys. So, but it's not even an opinion. It's just like, you know, like a fucking, like a quote. Be vigilant.
Yeah.
Keep your eyes open.
Be safe, man.
Always
check your six, you know?
Yeah.
In everything, not physically like while you're walking. I mean, yeah, physically while you're walking down the street, but I mean, what you do in life, what you choose to do, make sure you watch your own back too, because sometimes you're the only one who's gonna watch your own back. that's how I feel about that part of all the protesting. Is you know, I'm not cool with roads being blocked and stuff, like with them blocking roads and everything.
Be safe.
And you know,
you have to be safe.
You have to be safe. And you know, I saw something, and I think it's a great idea for in the event if you are in one of these situations where you're stopped and there's a mob ahead of you of people, you know, and it's not controlled by authority or anything. I'm like, this is just a bunch of people, you know.
Yeah.
I think it's totally okay for the cars to convene with each other and have the front car start rolling forward slowly, like 5 miles an hour. At a speed that nobody can get hurt. So you're not running people over.
Yeah.
And have every car behind that car just follow slowly. And
you
then eventually the mob, you can't stop the people, can't get in the middle of it, you know? No, you just keep going, you know?
Yeah.
And the only problem with something like that is, hey, if in the event...
Stay frosty.
in the event that, you know, so that a bunch of them try to hold the front car, which is very bad. I mean, if that was on camera,
if
that was on camera, that's just gonna make them look bad. That's just gonna make the mob look bad if they're trying to hold cars in. But I think just keep pushing. I would be totally fine with the car behind me pushing against my bumper to get through. Like pushing against my bumper, I don't give a fuck right now.
Yeah. I gotta clock in 10 minutes.
We're all a team. All of us just became a team right now.
Yeah.
So that we can get to where the hell we need to go, because all these motherfuckers are, you know, doing what they need to do to make themselves feel better.
Yeah. So it's a thing. But I do agree with moving slowly. Yeah. I completely agree with moving slowly.
Yeah,
if you're moving at a creep, nobody's going to get hurt. Go ahead and move at a creep. And you know what? People are aware enough, like, you know what? I don't want to get ran over today. Unless it's like a T. Edmund Square type of deal. But I don't think we're there yet. You know?
I don't know where we're at.
Yeah,
I saw
seriously.
An interesting post today. It's all like, the apocalypse is already happening. It's being televised. The apocalypse is being televised right now.
Nice.
It's like, wow, that's a little bit, I can't say that's far from the truth. Fuck. Yeah. You know, people are killing people. Like, when was it that the dominant subject on social media, not just with words, but with pictures and videos, is people killing people?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I mean, that's the rise of technology. It's only gonna get worse until it gets better.
Yeah.
This is just the beginning. We as us being 28, being able to go ahead and have technology at our fingertips to go ahead and record something live.
Yeah.
To social media instantly. This is something of the future when we were young.
Yeah, it was something that you thought only the news was capable of doing.
Yeah,
when we were younger.
So, but the thing is it's only gonna get more intense. I mean, you're gonna have augmented reality with Oculus Rifts and 3D images to go ahead and be like, yeah, those guys are recording a whole show, but I'm just looking back there in their garage.
Yeah, I'm in their garage. Right
I'm
now.
In their garage with them. Yeah. You know, it's going to get worse before it gets better. And that's with many, many things in life. You know, when you're going ahead and, like, working out, for example. When you haven't worked out for years and you start working out and it gets worse.
But this is a little bit different. This is technology.
This is technology.
This is new. Where human nature hasn't changed. Human nature is the same. Actually,
human nature has changed.
No, but human nature on this, dude. This is the basics of human nature. Everything that humans do, they destroy after a while.
Okay.
It's guaranteed that no matter how long something goes on for, it either changes or it's destroyed.
Okay.
Like that's the only way, because the bad shit is never gonna go away. There's no way to make the bad shit go away.
You can't.
Because it's human nature.
Yeah.
It's human nature to be bad. It's human nature to be evil and all that stuff.
It's human nature to be selfish.
Yeah, it's all human nature. So until you take away the means of conveying all those, the hatred, all those things, it's never going to go away.
Well, isn't another form of it to go ahead and just let it burn out?
Will technology ever burn out? It might.
I would think it would. Because it's going to become so readily available.
Yeah.
Every house is going to come with augmented reality windows where you can go ahead and tell the temperature. And the thing is, it's Moore's Law. Moore's Law establishes that technology is only getting faster and faster. And I mean, right now, I think it's like every 2 months or something like that. It used to be like 5 months. It used to be a few years. It's only getting faster and faster until soon we're gonna have augmented reality and contacts, and until they just go ahead and open up your eyelid and just put it in there, they've already done that, or it's not in America, but they go ahead and put some contact underneath your iris and it fixes your eyes better than it does laser repair.
Interesting,
because it's like permanent contacts that fix your eyes.
Interesting.
And let us listen to the
finish your thought first.
That was pretty much it, but let us see what's going on here. Technology will surpass our control. that's the Matrix, but at the same time, most likely, technology will most likely surpass us.
Are you talking about like AI, like as far as surpassing us? Or are you talking about losing control? Because the loss of control is going to be because of AI, and I do very much feel that that's a possibility, but just a possibility right now. I would hope that right now humans are smart enough to not give computers or machines too much control and not let Terminator happen kind of shit, you know? I would hope that, but hey, I don't put it past anyone to be able to say, hey, just let the machine do it. I mean, we're all, we got cars doing it. We got the fucking Tesla, and I heard that there was the first reported fatality in the Tesla car.
Okay.
Because of the autopilot.
Yeah.
I'm not fucking surprised.
Yeah.
I am not surprised at all.
I'm not surprised.
You're going fucking 60, 70, 80 miles an hour on a freeway where everybody else is, there's no other computer. You're the only car probably likely in your vicinity
that's
being controlled by a fucking robot. I would not trust it at all. At all.
Have you guys ever...
I cherish my life way too much to put my hands my life in the hands of a machine.
It's what you just said, is that everybody else around you isn't using it.
Yeah.
That's statistically not in your favor.
No, correct. No,
yeah,
because
it's statistically
nothing,
not in your favor.
There will never be anything, as far as driving goes, because driving demands the uses of all your senses. It demands a lot out of the human being, concentration-wise and stuff.
A lot of subconscious nowadays.
And that's something that I don't think you can program a computer to be able to do.
You can't program
to think like a human on the road, to be able to make those decisions.
Those split decisions.
You can't do that.
You could try. You could try, but, you know, that's, yet again, that would be something... Years.
The only thing that I would trust in a situation with the Tesla right now, I would trust that car in stop-and-go traffic. If it was stop-and-go traffic, I would trust it. Because I can guarantee we're only moving at 5 miles an hour, I'm not changing lanes, and the only thing the car has to do is not hit the car in front of it, which I fully trust a computer to be able to do that.
Yeah.
To not make contact with the object
right
in front.
Right now, I do not trust a car to go ahead and drive for me just because there isn't more people using it.
Yeah, that's a good point as well.
No, I would definitely go ahead and start that movement towards everybody else not driving because I just recently took a class called LES. It was about technology in the future and stuff like that. But the thing is, if everybody's using it, you can use less space on the roads because nobody's in control.
Yeah.
But at the same time, cars could go faster at the same time as well because, yet again, nobody's in control. So a car comes right onto the freeway. This car and all the cars around it know about it. Well, yeah. What are you...
Lighter.
I have no idea. It might be with your piece over there.
No. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So... what about forensics? Easy way to manipulate an identity.
We're talking about other shit. I had a comment about what you just said.
Okay.
About God.
Like cars.
About everybody using it, and I forgot. Let's continue on.
Anyway. So what forensics? Honestly. Imagine what it was 50 years ago. Imagine what it was when Sherlock Holmes became something of a book. You know? It's only going to get easier and easier to be fooled, or it's going to get easier and easier to get caught. Nowadays, there's a camera everywhere. There's a camera everywhere.
I wish I had the statistics on me. Is it Europe? I think it's Europe. It's one of the European countries. The amount of cameras, I think it's 3 to 1 on the for people. They have like 3 times as many cameras as they have people.
Oh, wow.
It's one of those European countries, yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah,
you can't do nothing there.
But this is the funny thing. This is how I feel about all of it.
Okay.
But this is coming from, this is a very personal opinion, and it's very much based on my lifestyle. I don't give a shit about all the cameras. The moment I walk out of my house, I don't give a shit if I'm being watched.
Yeah, I gotta go to work.
I,
gotta,
I'm doing things that are,
I gotta go,
you know,
take
what?
Care of my
and,
life.
And in a weird way, it keeps me from in check. It keeps me from doing things, and I would hope it keep other people too. But you know, I feel like it just keeps me on a straight path. You know, I would not, it not my house. My home is the only place where I would.
Yeah, you have your smartphone or your.
I would not want any monitoring in my house. The government said one day, "Hey, we're gonna put a camera in your house." But like, fuck no, you're not.
Yeah.
No, fuck no. I wouldn't even want that outside of my house. But if you want to go ahead and put a camera right there at the end of the street,
and make it high quality, at the entrance of my neighborhood, go
for it. I don't give a shit. Like, you know? And I feel sometimes that people who are against it, they're like, what do you have to hide?
What do you have to hide?
you just don't want people in your business? Then fuck. Like, come on, you're part of a fucking world, dude. You're not the only one who lives in this fucking world, you know? Like,
seriously.
But you are the only one in your house, and that's where I think the privacy is deserved, in the privacy of your own home, you know, that saying, you know?
Yeah.
And I feel that that should be the sacred ground.
It should always be a safe haven.
Yeah,
it should always be sanctuary.
Your home.
But when you get out of the house, definitely, it's like
you are part
of society. You are part of our group. You are human race. It is not you against the world. It is us against not killing everybody else.
Exactly.
Yeah. let us.
And
not,
I feel the same thing with the phone too. You know, people complain about, oh, I don't want them to have access to this, access to that. I'm like, you know what? I wouldn't want people having access to, you know, my bank account, my passwords, all that stuff. But hey, guess what? If you do online banking, somebody out there can take your shit. You're not.
It's given already.
Don't think you're so safe. I'm the only one who knows my password. No. You are not. Because when you put your password into a place, somebody else now knows your password.
Even if it's encrypted. If your password is encrypted.
I was taught. Okay. I should very much reword it. I'm gonna reword this because I don't want to. I need to reword this right. But I learned at one point while I was doing web design, there is a way, and it's not a very hard way to get people's passwords, encrypted passwords, just by going onto a website. It's not hard. It's seriously just going into the source code and doing a little bit of manipulation using a separate program to decrypt. It's not hard. It's something that I could do if I wanted to be malicious. I could go and take somebody's password and steal their money. It's not a hard thing to do. So my point of all that is, you're not fucking special. You don't want people seeing the pictures on your phone? Guess what? You're not special enough for people to want to see the pictures on your phone. You know, I'm sorry, but that's just the way I feel about it.
Yeah.
Like, and I don't care if I download apps, all this stuff, giving access to this and that. I'm like, well, as long as they can't take my money from me or fraud me or whatever, you know, as long as that doesn't happen, which it could.
I found that shit, Justin.
It could, but no, nobody's special enough to where your shit is like yours. The only way that you get to keep a password is to never, ever put it on the internet. That's the only way. It can never touch the internet.
Like a safe.
Yeah.
Use an act. Let's just go backwards.
So, I don't know, that's how I feel about the whole... people are so anal about stuff. Oh, I don't want the government to have access to my pictures. Why? What, they're gonna find some sexy stuff? Guess what? Seriously. But guess what? They can go ahead and look in the person's phone right there. And I'm sure they'll find worse. I'm like, how special are you? Like, come on. Like, I don't know.
It goes into what is so bad that you're trying to hide. But the thing is I feel like people think that, oh, I went and hung out with some girls. I went and hung out with some girls, and my girlfriend wouldn't like that very much if the government had access to it. And it's like, dude, the government doesn't give a fuck about you going ahead and being fallacious. The government doesn't give a shit about you doing all that shit. If you want, you can actually grab my phone, and then we can switch it out.
Yep, I'm gonna do that. Switching phones. I wonder how my phone's doing. I'm testing out this new portable charger that my mom got me on my phone right now, so hopefully it's doing well. Let's see. Actually, it's doing well. Good. Fuck yeah!
We have been recording for a minute, though.
You're right. How long have we been going on for?
1 hour ago.
An hour? Alright. It's time to wrap it up.
Okay.
We need to start having like a timer or something.
Unless you're Edward Snowden. Well played.
All right, you guys. Well, we had a pretty good we had a pretty good show today. We hit our hour point, so
yeah.
we're gonna try to cut it at an hour. So, last week we went for an hour and a half, and we're trying not to do
too much. We're not trying to fucking eye rape you right
now.
Yeah,
we're not trying to fucking take up all this time. You know?
Yeah, serious.
So fucking A, this was a good week, and I'm gonna let Bryant go ahead and take us out.
All right, everybody. Thank you again so much for joining in. My name is Bryant.
I'm Justin.
Thank you again. Have fun. Have a good week.
Peace out. Oh, I am way too lazy to go over the editor now. That's so far away.